These were some of the farmers who had an opportunity to visit the neighboring state of Arunachal Pradesh in India. Through the support of WWF Bhutan, they were taken on a study tour to learn, share and exchange ideas with the farmers there. All of them were entering an airport for the first time in their life. As they entered the airport, they were equally excited and nervous. The real excitement for them was when they approached and boarded the aircraft. Soon they were on air. And Tezpur was their destination. In Tezpur, the farmers were greeted at a hotel by staff from WWF India.
During this visit, it itself would be a learning process for the people in India, especially the people in Arunachal Pradesh, because it is not only the people from Bhutan would learn. Through the interactions, also people from Arunachal Pradesh could learn, you know, what is going on in Bhutan. So also it will be encouraging for people of Arunachal Pradesh to see similar activities going on in neighboring countries like Bhutan, you know, and also which is a culturally has significant in both the countries.
Hello, good morning. Kaisi dile? I've been in WWF for almost 9 years. Huh? Aji sangla gale jang WWF ko ang legal ngi ningu de na ningu office aji camp office Assam ga thak Assam gala lekin project office aji thora gati aji tawang tawang girang nang chuna chinong aji Assam ge themang ga dilo themang aji gangbo changla changla lo yaku changla ilosa ai lam ga Asi nongmen gi ji na si ta briefing alo ai.
Excited to experience and explore, the group hurriedly moves towards the car for a long journey to a village called Thembang in Dirang.
This is the Balikpung. We are still in Assam, but once we'll cross the gate, then we are inside Arunachal Pradesh. This is is also a place where I have to just go and show them the identity card.
While Pema was declaring the identity card, the car stopped for a few minutes at the checkpoint. Many of them said the environment is different on the other side of the checkpoint. It was a long drive from the plains to bumpy Himalayan roads. When the car reached Thambang village, it was pitch dark. Thambang village is well known for conservation of its forests and homestay facilities.
Research akan ba Japanese ko uye. Dustin Baradin Chui Chui Dela. Wagay research akan chache u chache chache chui dele ture nitre u aha chui chui ashe bak chache chulun. Uye homestay pila ashe thaga. Dablong epa ki homestay chui kitulani. Ole dishi rul chui. Toshang onye toshang zantu uye ipsa onye die chut bengi. Rup ture nitre. Newman Bionina, Golden, Natangali, Wanging, Choshi, Purinar Bucks, the same grindy, the Toshang Pilu Binji, the onion, Goids are ready here, Garant had gave Binji and listen. Oh, yeah, a red jay on your malin bear. Golden.
During the evening, the group was invited to meet the members of the community conserved area in Thambang. And after a warm welcome and interaction with one another, beautifully dressed women prepared to offer locally brewed ara and bangchang. And if one refused their offers, this is what happened. Many villagers here say that they love Bhutanese songs and dances. The night ended with merrymaking. As the dawn breaks, one can see the beautiful Thambang village sitting magnificently on the mountaintop, surrounded by lush green forests. It is said that the community themselves preserved their forests without interference from the government. Today, the community manages more than 600 square kilometers of forest areas, declaring it as a community conserved area. The village is also known for its homestay facilities for people visiting the village to enjoy the nature and culture.
The Chimdani, only the
New knowledge and new experience, the group is ready to move to their next destination in Tawang. En route, they cross over a place called Dirang and also other beautiful landscapes. This is Dirang, and Pema said that the people of Dirang originally came from eastern Bhutan.
Dirang, we have local what you call people who are basically Sangla. We call ourselves Munpa, but in our language we say that we are Sangla people. We have many relationship with in terms of our origin from Bhutan. So you also have Sharchokpa in Bhutan, so we share similar language. We also share similar culture and traditions.
Enlightened by Pema on the origin of people of Dirang, the next stop was at Sela Pass. While driving towards Sela Pass, the farmers were amazed by its scenic beauty. As the gateway to Tawang, Sela Pass is also one of the highest passes in Arunachal Pradesh. The Bhutanese farmer gathers around Pema to know more about the magnificent Sela Pass.
During pilgrimage season, we have a lot of people coming in from Bhutan. They come from Sakteng and Lerak.
After spending few hours, the team leaves for their destination in Tawang, which is more than 70 kilometers away. The next morning, everybody was excited to visit the Tawang Monastery, one of the iconic Buddhist monasteries in the district.
This is the Tawang Monastery main prayer hall, huh? And this is basically whenever you heard about Torga and Dungur, right? Torga and Dungur. This is the place where this whole thing will happen. The ceremony, main ceremony, the dance and all.
The Bhutanese were received warmly by Lama Thukten, and he briefly spoke about the monastery.
The monastery was established since 1680, and 1681 it was fully completed, so more than 334 years ago. The founder of the Tawang Monastery, his name is called the Merak Lama Lodre Gyatso, and he is the main disciple of the fifth Dalai Lama, and he ordered to him to build this monastery. So at that time he has some rule, if their family, there is a tradition, so medicine is compulsory to go and be monk here. So the rule is still going on. And the people in the 7th century, you know, there's one king we call the Gebokala Ongpo, and he's the prince, the Kandawa Sangmo. And the fort is here and behind our monastery. And someone they are saying in the historical, they are saying that there's a palace, you know, and this whole area is the palace of the Kebokalo Angpo.
From here, my colleague Jaya Upadhyaya, so she has been in our office like for a long time. She will take over, and then from here, once we'll visit, you know, some more villages in Tawang, then after that she will take you all to Zimidang after that.
They paid their homage and prayers at the monastery. And soon they were on their way to visit the villagers of Chaksam village. Here the villagers were happy to meet the Bhutanese farmers and were also excited to learn from them. Human-wildlife conflict is the key issue in this community, just like it is in Bhutan. However, when Bhutanese farmers shared success stories of electric fencing and wish to provided by the government free of cost, the farmers of Chaksam were excited to learn more about it. The community of Chaksam never heard of electric fencing until today. Soon they were called by a group of women working in the field for a Bhutanese song. After that melodious song, the Bhutanese farmers were back on the road to Jimithang. It was a bumpy ride through a narrow road. In Jimithang, the Bhutanese met with the village headman. He made a brief introduction of his village and the sacredness of his valley. The village headman then took the Bhutanese to the sacred Korsam Chorten. Every one of them had heard about this sacred Chorten, which resembled the sacred Chorten Kora in Tashiansi back home, but did not know much about its history. Jimithang is also one of the sacred habitats for the black-necked cranes. That was the key reason why the community came together to protest against the government's plan to build a mega hydropower plant.
Jaka ye, yaha tempo ne ta mara pura jaka kharab ho jata pura ne. To dusra mara ye crane jo abhi ya naam ta abhi thung thung karne jo bolta. Ye naam ta ye baat pura mara pija ka jese mara show hai. जो जगह पे पंक्चर नहीं का शो है वो खराब हो जाएगा बोल के हम लोग तो नहीं देगा बोल के हम लोग पूरा बात करके हम लोग फोन किया अभी गवर्नमेंट अभी अपना मंत्री लोग जी लोग पे वो लोग भी अभी होगा बोल के अभी हम लोग का किला रह गया।
The Bhutanese farmers also met with the village youth group there. According to them, the youth group plays an important role in their community in decision-making process like conservation and waste management. Some of the Bhutanese farmers wished if the children could stay back with them and help their community just like this youth. People here mostly depend on livestock. Many said they collect rice and other grains from Bhutan and even some of their livestock. In the evening, the village headman invited the Bhutanese for a program hosted by him. Everyone was mesmerized by the Achilamucham performed in honor of the visitors. Then came this beautiful woman with bowl of fara, where even the non-drinkers were made to drink. And the team also performed Bhutanese dances. The next day, Rajeshri from WWF India took the group to West Kemang district. On the way, he showed beautiful landscape and also the Bhutan-India international boundary.
Now we are in a place called Mandla Top, almost near Mandla Top. So what we see in front of us is the range called Gorichen, Arunachal's highest mountain range called Gorichen. And in the middle of it, there's a peak, a pyramid-shaped peak, which is most probably Arunachal's highest peak. It's called Kangto. It's around 7,000 meters high. So just below that, you can see a valley, which is directly below Kangto. That is the Sangthi Valley. That is a village called Sangthi. It's in a broad river valley. You can access it by Dirang. It's around 15-20 kilometers from Dirang. That is a place where black-neck cranes visit every winter. There are only two recorded places in Arunachal where black-neck cranes visit in winter. Sangthi Valley is one of them.
This was the final scenic view of the snow-capped mountains of Arunachal Pradesh as the farmers group headed towards Thumpo Melongkar in West Kemang district. In this region, people still practice shifting cultivation. Maize was their staple food, but now they produce tomatoes for commercial purposes.
According to our WWF colleague, he said that it has been 3 or more years. The farmers actually changed the cropping pattern here. They have totally dropped the cultivation of maize and they have opted for tomato. And the main reason behind is because tomato fetches good price from Assam, because people here are actually supported by Assamese people in terms of tomato seeds, in terms of inputs, fertilizers, and then pesticides, chemicals, also the missionaries from there. So once the tomato is also like harvested, then the product is also exported to Assam. So that is another concern that the WWF India is actually sharing with us. So if this kind of cultivation goes on, their main concern is, one is on the human health because of high input of chemicals. The other is also the adaptability of the tomato in this area. And the other one is the side effect on the water resources, especially the water, the animals, the insects and the microorganisms living in the water. And the other is the large volume of collection of bamboo from the red panda habitat.
It's been 2 years since the farmers of Thumpo Melongkar took up tomato business. Farmers gave up their staple food as it required hard work with less income. Farmers here could harvest tomatoes at least 4 times a year, which provided good income.
Yongla khelani men mojburu lami ama tinongam cha ama jing amnang nang manasiga अम्बो खर्चा जेप्सोला अनि इन्कम दिनबुला अनि आलुगेन सबसे पहिले त आसी प्राइमरी बेसिस का टोमेटो याङकिरङ सासबुला अनि ननु स्कूल का सुपोचेनि हाङबो ननु बाका थारिङ थारिङ लामगु दिलुगा मोइ मालन थाङबो अनि तो टोमेटो लेका अनि उसे कल्टिभेसन आलुगा उसमें हार्वेस्ट पेन आसी 3-4 टाइम्स उनला उनके आपसे इनकम आसी जेप्सो उनला तो धीरे धीरे ओमा थारबु गोरपुगा थारबु निंथुरगा सोइल फर्टिलिटी कम छला नेक्स्ट साल का कम आके आगे धीरे धीरे यंग तक खेलना उनके आशी ओम गवर्नमेंट का वो अपील आन छा ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग के जो कि आशी मेन हेल्थ के लिए और मेन हम वो आशी सोइल हम वो के लिए सेविंग के लिए उनके आशी गवर्नमेंट का अपील को आन छा
Back in the car, the Bhutanese farmer said it was a big business, but at the cost of the natural environment by using more chemicals. It was dark when the team reached back to Tezpur. Back in the plains, Nilam Dutt, who runs an organic farm, welcomed the Bhutanese farmers to explore Pahoi grains. Nilam took the farmers around the farm and guided them to a greenhouse with varieties of flower saplings. Rearing earthworm to make organic manure for his farm was one of the highlights at the farm.
Samgi nai ta zum jibe jin kongi da ani lui zo ta da ani se garden jin ne bala ta ha ani di lui zo be ma ye shinalo tharaba lu su per ani be ni pan be do su no sam tan do su ni
la be mi di ashi ya lu tu ge kam nang gi so wa sanam lu chung di mi gi mi si su lu na mi sam phin thoni me se su ni la di da chi khalu ta khong su gi nek up taw ma do la ta lu tho di ta pe be o chin dinal jae me mo la ta ani chi duni me ba china di da chi khalu khong su gi ne so chang thap de me la chi kha be ra ta ne so chang thap de me te ne ja du wi kam lu te ne ya tene duni be la nga chi gi be o chin ja in se wachin la di chi cham chi byong wala ta khongi na zum chi byong wachin ti la chi cham chi salar membe se shunila te ha po ni membe se shunila ja duni chi da ni a du se te duni chi han be da ha po ni be da lu ti mi de lu nam se mi pen jo ge kon pen da lu nam se pen thoni me se han be su se shunila
we are a multi purpose farm so the we have different aspects of farming in different ways we have fisheries apart from fisheries we not only grow fish but we also breed fish which is also another component of the farm. We are also concentrating on local ornamental fish along with some very good catfish which are very indigenous to our region which we have started breeding. Third is we started dairy and with dairy like we collect cow urine and cow dung and we convert it into biomanure like vermicompost and with cow urine we make biopesticide with the help of local indigenous herbs and medicinal plants. We have a small duckery unit where we have ducks. Then we also have a small flower nursery and we grow healthy saplings. We grow rice where we also grow rice with fish, which is called fish cum pediculture. We get two things from the same place. And we are also maintaining a small gene pool of local rice from the region, from the seven states in and around our state, where we have around 78 different varieties of rice. We also have a kind of another program which we try to save the seeds for vegetables as well and do little bit of vegetable breeding.
The Pahoi grains was the last visit for the farmers as they head back home after a week-long visit to Arunachal Pradesh. They said good experience, knowledge and memories would forever remain in their heart and soul.
After coming back from Arunachal Pradesh, we would also be doing similar kind of study in the places like Bhumta, from where we took these farmers, and then Shamga, and see how this study tour has actually helped them to improve their livelihood and what kind of knowledge and information which they gather from there, actually they have implemented here or not. If they have implemented, then how it has helped them, their livelihood. If they haven't implemented, then what reasons actually has stopped them from implementing those new knowledges. Yeah.